Sometimes you need to cut out something that is too complicated for the pen tool. Think of a tree with all of its branches and leaves, or an animal with its fur. Even a person with long hair presents a challenge when it comes to cutting them out with the pen tool. Thankfully, there's an option for cutting these complicated shapes out in Photoshop that is easier and less time-consuming than using the pen tool. It's called the channel mask. In order for the channel mask to work, the object that you're cutting out must be set against a background that's relatively clean, having a good contrast in value and color. Objects that are set against a cluttered background won't work as well with the channel mask. For this palm tree image, the leafy part of the tree that is set against the sky will mask well with channels. As you can see, the trunk of the tree has a cluttered background behind it, showing a building, shrubbery, and a bunch of cars. So the trunk of the tree is not ideal for channel masking. Because of that, we have cut out the trunk of the tree with the pen tool and created a path for it that we will combine with the top of the tree later on. To begin channel masking, you'll first need to find the channel that has the most contrast between what you want, in this case the tree, and what you don't, the sky. Over on the channel panel, you can look at each channel individually by clicking to the right of the name on the channel, either red, green, or blue. In this instance, it looks like the blue channel has the most contrast between the tree and the sky behind it. Our first step here is to make a copy of the blue channel. Because the red, green, and blue channels are actual components of this image, you can't make changes to them directly without changing the whole image. That's the reason we have to work on a copy of the channel. The idea here is to modify this copy of the blue channel with the tools we have available in Photoshop to make the object that we want, the tree, all black, and the stuff we don't want, the sky, all white. To start this process, we'll use curves. Make sure that the copy of the blue channel is selected first, and the eyeball for that channel copy is turned on. Go up to the Image menu, then down to Adjustments, and choose Curves. We're going to be working with the small triangles under the histogram in the Curves window. Dragging these triangles towards the center will make the whites whiter and the blacks blacker. It's interesting to note here that you could use the Curves tool to push all the whites all the way white, and the blacks all the way black by bringing both these triangles to the middle. The problem with that is the resulting image, especially around the detailed leaves of this palm tree, become pixelated and aliased. For a more realistic mask, the tips of the palm fronds should retain some gray tones. Because of that, we're only going to move the arrows towards the center a little bit. Move the black arrow towards the center until the input value reads 35. And move the white arrow towards the center until the input value reads 230. This setting creates a little detail in the cloud section of the image, and it leaves a good amount of gray on the tips of the palm fronds. The next step is to push this image closer to black and white using some more detailed tools, namely Dodge and Burn. We'll start with the Dodge tool. It's located just above the pen tool and looks like a white circle with a stick coming out of the bottom. Make sure that the options toolbar for the Dodge tool is set up like mine. First, make sure that you're using a completely soft brush, setting the hardness of the brush to zero. Then change the range setting to highlights. The Dodge tool makes things brighter, and using the Dodge tool in the highlights range ensures that you can dodge over something that's black and the tool will not try to make it white. Then make sure the exposure dropdown is set between 10 and 20%. Begin to use the Dodge tool to erase the cloud detail around the outside of the tree. Get between the palm fronds, but be careful not to dodge the edges of the palm fronds too much because it will get rid of the subtle gray tips that are needed to create a realistic channel mask. When you're done, the area all around the top of the tree should be completely white. Next, switch to the Burn tool. It's located in the submenu underneath the Dodge tool and looks like a hand making a C. Again, make sure that the options bar for the Burn tool looks like mine. First, set the brush to be completely soft, with a hardness setting of 0. Then set the range dropdown to shadows. For the Burn tool, this setting means that you can burn over an object that is white, and it will not try to darken it. The tool will only work on gray values that are close to black. Finally, set the exposure value to somewhere between 10 and 20%. size the burn tool to be about the width of one of the palm fronds, and then begin painting with it from the center of the tree outwards to the tips of the palm fronds. This will thicken up the palm fronds a little bit. Be careful not to darken the tips of the leaves too much so that they can retain gray and the channel mask will continue to look realistic. Next, we want to change everything except the top of this tree to pure white. There are a number of ways to accomplish this in Photoshop. For our purposes, let's use the lasso tool. First, make a circle around the top of the tree that encloses all of the palm fronds and is within the area that you made completely white with the dodge tool. Then inverse the selection, a Command-Shift-I, so that everything except the top of the tree is selected. Then we will use the Fill dialog box to fill that area with white. Go up to the Edit menu and select Fill. From the Contents menu, select White, and then click OK. Now we need to make a selection of the top of the tree using the channel mask that we just created. In the Channels palette, hold down Command and click on the thumbnail next to the blue copy channel. You should notice that everything that is white in the channel is what Photoshop selects. In this image, that means that the sky is selected and the thing that we want, the tree, is not selected. Because of this, we need to inverse our selection by going up to the Selection menu and choosing Inverse or by clicking Shift-Command-I on the keyboard. The black outline of the tree should now be the only thing that is selected. Now we're ready to combine the selection we have of the top of the tree with the trunk of the tree. If you remember, that path has already been created for us and is waiting for us over in the Paths palette. With the marching ant still circulating around the top of the tree, go to the Paths palette and hover your pointer over top of the thumbnail on the palm tree center path. This time, hold down Command plus Shift. Notice that when you're holding down Command plus Shift, that your cursor becomes a square with a plus sign inside of it. This means that the selection you're about to make will add to the selection that is already active with the marching ants. Go ahead and click on the thumbnail next to the palm tree center while holding down Command Shift, and you should see the new selection that has the top of the palm tree combined with the center of the palm tree. Now the selection is ready to be turned into a layer mask. Go back to the Layers palette and make sure that you click on the Exercise Channel Mask layer. After that, click the Add Layer Mask button, and the selection of the tree will become a mask for that layer, separating the tree from its background. You should now be looking at this palm tree perfectly cut out against the gray background that is supplied with this PSD. That completes the channel mask exercise. Please remember to save your work before moving on to the next section.